Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Sveta Smirnova, and I work in my school support. But today I would not be talking about troubleshooting. Instead, I will tell you how to write prepars query rewrite plugins. We will introduce new SQL syntax. We'll work with result sets, modify variables, and have variables in our plugins, and I will give a little bit summary. But why I, support engineer, care about this coding? Just because I work in support, I work on problems. And I also visit user conference, and my users, people, and not only people, this picture was taken in FSDM last year, they complain. They complain about MySQL doesn't have features they want. It cannot make toast. It does not support some SQL clauses which exist in standard or whatever other databases. This is again from last year's FOSDEM talk, Marcus Weinand, about filter clause which is in Postgres and not in MySQL. But, yeah. It's my command line client, it's my terminal, it's a little bit bigger. Filter clause in MySQL. So you may think it's about like 1 year passed and developers did this feature. But not, it's not exist in the user manual. There is no filter, it's few factor, find and set, but no filter. So how is it done? It's with 181 lines of code, including comments, and with new query rewrite plugin interface. It's now let's move to writing plugins, but before a little bit of history. The first plugins were introduced in version 5.7.5. There were only two types of plugins. It's pre-parse and post-parse. So how it worked, it's then your client connected to MySQL server. It's a pre-parse plugin, catched this connection, and you can introduce, make something. You can code something and affect further query execution. And then after parse stage queries parsed, it comes post-parse plugin, which you can just tell optimizer how to use index and do more low-level part. Today, this is a bit more complicated. There is no query rewrite plugins per se, but they are part of audit plugin interface, and you have access to much many steps. But we are interested in this one, it's MySQL audit parse pre-parse. So because we will be introducing new SQL syntax, and for new SQL syntax, we need to step in before parsing. Okay, so this is plugin skeleton. That's what you need to write plugin. This is C++ code, or you can see. This is first you need to include header, it's plugin audit. Then you must create a pointer to the plugin, that's type MySQL plugin. This is function which is init function for your plugin. It can be any name, it's just a must use to this interface. Same applies for the main function of the plugin. It will be called, it's like entry point, so then event happens, this function will be called. And then you must define a plugin descriptor and declare plugin. So a little bit more about plugin descriptor. This is interface version. This is a function which will do the job. And here we must tell plugin in which events we are interested in. We are interested in MySQL audit parse pre-parse because that's we are stepping before parser. But we can also use MySQL audit parse all. There are shortcuts. They must be in order, so they like I show you on this slide. So they must be in this order, and you can skip last. And here is a plugin declaration. It's like if anybody wrote MySQL plugins. So who wrote probably know this. What you need is a type of plugin. It's pointer to descriptor. This is name. It's any string. After, short description of plugin. License. This is init function for the plugin. And here is, for my case, it was not declared. It's dnit, version, if a plugin uses variables. And it has config options. And finally, flex. Okay, so this is a feature, I think, I'm not sure, I think it's 5.7 feature. MySQL has services for plugins. And we have memory management. So they can very easily work with, because with query rewrite plugin, we actually, we can allocate memory, and when we need to free it. And so we can do it in the init function, but we can just pass it to service for memory management, and MySQL will do it for us. So I created only one key, so it should be array of keys which must be freed. After that, so I created only one key, and in the init function, I registered this my array of keys which key pointers to memory which must be freed in the init stage. Okay, so now we are ready to implement filter. So what is the filter? It's SQL 2003 standard. And, so it's like you write function of something, and like a filter. So it's it's applied only for this part of this function. MySQL supports only group of this function, so plugin supports only them, not what is in standard. Practically, a filter is case when full, then bar else null. So that's pretty easy. So you just need to catch the statement and rewrite it to case. Here is type should be bar. And here, how is it done? Is it done? It's first I check if do static cast to. Here a little bit about function parameters. Freed is MySQL freed object. If you attended Valery's session about GDB, here you know it's main. It's object which created for each connection freed. It contains freed variables. It contains security contents. Everything. This is a class of the event, which is our audit plugin event, and this is an event itself. So what we must to do, we need to cast our event to event parse from more abstract class. Then we can check if event subclass is our subclass. And then we can rewrite our query. So here is what is important. It's event parse has a member called query. It's original query, so we can have access it, and we can check if its query conforms matches pattern. I use it a regular expression here, and in case we can rewrite it, I just created new string called rewriting query. So a real plugin has more cases for all functions, all kinds of, here is a count star, but it's for counts field name, it's for everything. Just keep it. We need rewrite query. So we have a string rewritten query here, this string will be freed when it leaves the function, so we need to send it to MySQL, so it will be used forfeit. So here it's just I created helper functions. First, we register memory because it will be left after our filter function finish. Then we put to this new rewriting query our query, and then in the event parse it calls another member. It's called rewriting query. This is a query which was rewritten, so we can just point it to our rewritten query. And finally, this is important, you must set this flag. It tells MySQL which query was rewritten, and it should use this rewritten query and not original query. Okay, playing with syntax is fun, but can we do something more MySQL-ish? Of course, we can. MySQL 5.7 has a very nice feature called optimizer hints. What it does, it's MySQL also has optimizer switches and which allows you to turn one or another optimization on and off. But optimizer hints can allow you to do it for a single query, not for the thread, not for the server, only for single query and using this common syntax. Issue with with performance, MySQL performance, that's not only optimizer switches affect query execution, but also thread specific buffers such as temporary table size or join buffer size. Usually increasing this for the full server usually dangerous because it will be allocated for all threads. But for one thread, common workaround is just set this variable, run query, and set a variable to back to default. Issue with this workaround is you must process result set of each this. So you must set, discard result set, then use result set from this query, again run this query and discard some. This is not convenient. So that's why I introduced an extension for optimizer hint plugins. It's custom hint plugin, so I can just set the query, set the variable to new value. Okay, so how is it done? To implement custom hints, we need store previous value of the thread, which we are going to modify, then modify variables, and then return them back before sending result. Let's do it. First, we need to place to where to store variables. You can just define in the same file where you define plugin. So I just static map and will be will be created. If in the job, in the now function calls custom hint, we can put here is actually this is map of maps because plugin allows to change many more than one variable, so it calls like thread ID and the map of variable and value. So if we have a match, we create a map of thread variables, and then we do processing them. After that, we just store modified variables map, store this just created map. How to modify variables? That's easy, since we have access to MySQL thread. We can just, first we are storing previous value, just we can set thread variables, join both sides, and here we new value. And same for temporary table size and every other buffers. And to revert back, we first need tell audit plugin, tell MySQL what we need result. We need to step in a case when the result is sent to the client. So in the descriptor, we add one more event here. So MySQL audit general result. So we are interested. So we in the main function, we will check if it's parse pre-parse or if it's a general result. And then if it's we are in the general result, we search map for if it contains modified variables for the thread, then revert them back. So you can see it's from here. And finally, we erase modified variables because we changed them back already, and we are not going to move them back like next time, for example, if query is not reverting. Okay, so here is the result. Before custom plugin, this is taken on my laptop from with spinning disk, so that's why these numbers. It's big join, it's called, it took 25 seconds, and two on disk temporary table were created. It's, remember, it's 24. And with custom here plugins, it's 6 seconds, it's no disk-based temporary table created, it's all in memory, and full time speed gain. So this is how we can increase performance of our application with pre-parsed plugins. Okay, and last topic, it's variables. It's how to tune plugins. This is actually, it's not artificial example. It's called one of user conferences told me it's what they wanted to have backup database because they wanted the user have access to their MySQL server as through SQL, but they don't want to give access to shell. That time it was not possible, but now it's possible with plugins. So this works. Plugin works very pretty easy. Just backup server, very simple syntax. But MySQL does not backup source, so it supports many tools. It supports MySQL dump, MySQL pump, MySQL backup. It will be support extra backup as soon as it will support 5.7. And we need to pass options. For all these tools, we need to pass options. It's credentials, it's username and password, backup directory, and maybe some custom options like to compress or not compress or do something like this. For customization, we have access to MySQL free. Again, here, CTIP is THD, security context member, and we can get a user from here. Unfortunately, password, we cannot use password, so it should be either on client or toolname section in configuration file, or you can pass it as a custom option, which is not secure. Since we are backing up local server, I use MySQL DUnix port, which is actually socket. It's internally called socket system. Regarding customization, it's designed as a variable. So that's like in previous example, we said join buffer size, and here our temporary table size. So here we can set custom variables, backup dir, backup tool, or anything else. This is example only because plugin uses print variables. For global variables, you have to specify call these macros. Specify name of variable, how it will be printed to user, then a name of variable, how it will be used inside plugin, kind of variable, short description, and here is example, it's like a kind of enum, so it's tools, you could say limited amount of tools. Thread variables, it's almost same, but you use MySQL thread vars var str or enum, and don't specify variable name two times. And finally, we must add them to plugin declaration. It works exactly the same for global and thread variables. So we need to create this st MySQL sysvar array, put all variables, and last element must be null. And then we, in the declaration, we tell plugins to use this. For variables, we have variables. Okay, so I have 1 minute for summary. That's my 20 minutes talk. It's I could not tell more. I just have idea how it's that for backup login, I want to implement custom locks so the two users cannot run backup at the same time. You can have multiple find control at multiple steps of query execution. You can do much more, like crazy idea like I have, like you can combine it with HTTP server and you can just use MySQL to process your web request. So any crazy ideas are possible now. Code here is on my GitHub. It's all links are active. It's a filter custom plugin. More information is MySQL source directory in the plugin directory. This is a pretty simple plugin. This is working plugin. It's also in this manual pages. And today will be talked by Martin Hansen about his author of this interface. And on dinner, probably you will catch him and ask in me. Okay, thank you very much. I'm waiting you on dinner for questions.